श्रीमतीजी नाम जाए मन Today's lecture is on food and the topic of the lesson is ontodidactics. Ontodidactics deals with the philosophical as well as multidimensional approach for consumption of food. What to consume, how much to consume, and what are the various parameters of a realistic sattvic food. And it also implies inside, even though it is something connected with consumption of food, our Shastras believe that if food is properly consumed and distributed, food productivity, food security, food distribution services, then it is everything made inside. Proper food consumption, as per the Shastras, that involves also proper food productivity, proper food security and distribution, number one. And number two, we used to take lot of things. For knowledge, we want something. For health and hygiene, we want something. And for nutrition, our survival balance, we need something. For our nutrition and survival balance, we go for food. And for health, we go for drugs, medicine. For knowledge, we go for lot of exercises. For peace, we go for solitude or company or forest or house or fun, whatever it may be. But our Shastra says that food is the only solution for everything. That is the difference between Eastern and Western thought. To consider food as not only a nutrition provider, not only as a biological instigator, but also considering proper food induces you to get mental peace, to get intellectual maturity, to get spiritual solace, to get your own inner realization, for which each and every role of food is very significant in the inceptive level. So food is an initial tool for getting physical, mental, spiritual, social, collective, cultural, moral maturity. Number one, it is not only an initial tool but also is a supportive tool to your other works. Number three, it is an associate tool with all of your spiritual efforts. In your spiritual efforts, it is associative. In all of your endeavors, irrespective of the status, it is supportive and it is an initial step for everything. Western philosophy, they don't bother about food and they are not aware of this multi-level or multi-dimensional penetration of the power of food or the vigor of food in all spheres. So this type of a totalitarian study of food is not there available in the Western philosophy. Whenever we take autodidactics, I want to give these two points which I want to say once again. Number one, if you say about proper food consumption, that is implied with, that is pregnant with, that is incorporated with food management, food productivity, food distribution services, food security, and that is also a solution to the world poverty, world malnutrition, and the world's other various other problems like unemployment and various things. Everything starts from hunger, poverty, and this malnutrition problems. So it is a solution provided to everything. So the first point you have to understand is this type of food consumption is not only consumption. Having consumption as a proper methodology by which pre-consumption and post-consumption benefits are indwelling and they are assured, number one. And number two, this is not only a physical nourishment service, it deals with mental balancing, it deals with intellectual sharpness, it deals with the spiritual solace and self-comforting, it deals with comforting others and embracing others, it deals with universal fraternity and brotherhood. With food we can do anything. So Annam Brahma, God can do anything. God is in the form of food. So through food, in the form of God, we can do anything. That is a real philosophy which we are going to discuss in ontodidactics. When we come to this Anna, I believe that this should be also in the syllabus of yoga. Whether in the yoga or Vedanta, Ayurveda, in these three things it starts with Ahara Niyati. Second, it deals with Achara Niyati. Third thing, it deals with Abhyasa Niyati. So Abhyasa is a practice. In Yoga, Vedanta and in Ayurveda, the Abhyasa may be different. Yogacharya will be having his Abhyasa, Ayurveda is entirely different. Each and everybody, they will be having their experimentations and practices differently. But they all start from a common substratum or a common substantial base. That foundation is Ahara. Three people, both yoga. There are three schools of thought, wonderful thought. For your physical maturity to reach good balanced mind and intellect, Ayurveda is pushing you up. Making your mind and intellect facilitated for spiritual realization, yoga is pushing up to Vedanta. Vedanta is pushing either you to God or pulling God or dragging God to you by your bhakti. So these are the three major sciences. All these three sciences, they start with food. So I want to say a few points now. Number one, ahara lakshana or anna lakshana. You write it anna. Ahara is the method and anna is the substance. And dravya is the ingredient. If you say that it is rice, that is the dravya. And while it is in the status of being consumed, whether it is plain rice or cooked rice, that which is consumed, that is known as anna. And the consuming is known as ahara. So, the to be consumed element is dravya. The consumable element is known as anna. Consumed, while consumed, that particular element is given the name as ahara. So ahara is consumption and anna is the consumable, and the consumability promoted or promotable or to be promoted element or ingredient is known as dravya. So dravya becomes anna when it is for service. When you utilize the service, it becomes ahara. So anna is the basic name given by the Vedas. Anna maya kosha is the name of the body, not ahara maya kosha or dravya maya kosha. So anna is the spiritual nomenclature for food. And we have given few spiritual nomenclatures for anna also. If you worship God and take that food, it is known as anna. There are three types of worships. One is manasika, second is vyavaharika, third thing is kratusiddha. So that which is by mana, by your mental thought, if you surrender and submit, that becomes anna. If you offer it to God in the form of a kratu, that is a ritual, that becomes avish. The same thing if you offer by vyavahara, not by mere thinking, by doing something, sprinkling water, putting tulsi, that becomes prasad. So anna is the primary nomenclature of divine food. So divinity present inside the food, it is known as immanence. That immanent divinity is known as anna. The provoked divinity is known as avish. The invoked divinity is known as prasad. So these things are very special to us. So let us start with anna lakshana. I don't know whether I can complete this or not, but I will give the full skeleton of this today. One is anna lakshana. What are all the parameters for food? Second thing is anna dravya. We can eat anything. So a barbaric society, cannibalistic society, and nomadic society, all these people, they don't know any limitations. If they are hungry, whatever that is available. And even in emergent cases, we know that in lot of shipwreck cases, the people, they used to eat the other people who are left inside the ship. There are stories and there are real incidents. We cannot believe it unless we are subjected to that situation. So that knows no rule. Appetite knows no rule. Only that type of our moral stamina and spiritual courage should give us the energy as a substitute for the food which is not available, and give us the real noble path whereby we can select our food, wait for it, still sustain with more vigor. It should be given by our moral and spiritual courage. Stamina should give it. Otherwise, we will be victimized by surrounding. Whatever that is available, we may take. So we should have that courage.